In this lecture, we will see about the concept of virtualizations. So, firstly, we will see what is the virtualizations in cloud computing. So, virtualizations is the creation of virtual rather than the actual version of something. And something like as a server, desktop, a storage device, an operating system or network, a resource, etc. So, in another word, we also can say that virtualization is a technique which allows to share a single physical instance of resource or an application among multiple customers and organizations. It does by assigning a logical name to a physical storage and providing a pointer to the physical resource when demanded. So basically, virtualization is a technology that lets you create useful IT services using resources that are traditionally bound to hardware. It allows you to use a physical machine full capacity by distributing its capabilities among many users or environment. And in more practical term, imagine you have three physical servers. And these three physical servers are dedicated for the particular purpose. One is for the mail server, another is a web server, and the last one run internal legacy applications. So we have a three physical server, one for the mail server, another for the web server, and third one for the legacy applications. And each server used about 30% of its capacity, and this one is just a fraction of their running potential. And we know that the legacy app remain important to your internal operations. You have to keep them and the third server that host them right. Like as in this figure, you will see that there is a three component. One is for the mail, or we can say that one is for the mail server, second in one for the web server, and third one is used for the legacy applications. And each use only 30% of its capacity. 30% of its capacity. So after virtualizations, we can shift this legacy app to the any server, either it is on mail server or web server. So when we shifted this legacy app to the mail server through virtualizations, now this legacy app machine will be free. And mail server machine now have two services. First one was for mail services and second one for legacy services. Now machine one can now utilize 60% of its total capacity. And this will be possible with the help of virtualizations. There are different types of virtualizations, but before going on the type of virtualizations, first will we see what is the concept behind the virtualizations. So, creation of a virtual machine over existing operating system and hardware is known as a hardware virtualizations. A virtual machine provides an environment that is logically separate from the hardware or from the underlying hardware. The machine on which the virtual machine is going to create is known as a host machine. and the virtual machine refer as a guest machine. So which one is our own original hardware or original machine is known as a host machine, and which one is virtually or which one is a virtual machine is referred as a guest machine. Now there are various types of virtualizations, like as the first one is a data virtualization. So data that is spread all over can be consolidated into a single source. And data virtualizations allow companies to treat data as dynamic supply, providing processing capability that bring together data from multiple resources, easily accommodate new data source, and transfer data according to the user need. Data virtualization tools sit in front of multiple data sources and allow them to be treated as a single source, delivering the needed data in the required form at the right time to any applications or user. So in the given figure, we have a three sets of data. First, this one is the first two sets of data. This one is second set of data. And this one is the third set of the data. And with the help of hypervisor is a software applications for virtualizations. So with the hypervisor, we can virtualize these data into a single unit. Second one is the desktop virtualizations. Easily confused with the operating system virtualizations, which allow you to deploy multiple operating system on a single machine. In case of operating system virtualizations, you will be allowed to deploy multiple operating system. But in the case of desktop virtualizations, it allows a central administrator, or we can say that automated administration tool, to deploy simulate desktop environment to 100 of physical machine at once. In the traditional approach, there are physical installed desktop configured and update on the each machine. Desktop virtualizations allow admin to perform a mass configuration, update and security check on all virtual desktop. Third one is a server virtualizations. So server are computer designed to process a high volume of specific tasks really well, so other computer like laptop and desktop can do a variety of other tasks. Virtualization a server let it to do more of those specific function and involve partitioning it so that the component can be used to serve multiple functions. And next one is the operating system virtualizations. So this can be happen at the kernel. As we know that the kernel is the central task manager of an operating system. It is a useful way to run Linux and Windows environment side by side. Enterprises can also push virtual operating system to computes which reduce bulk hardware cost, since the component do not require such high out of the box capability. It increases security, since all virtual instance can be monitored and isolated. Limits time spent on the IT service, like as the software updations, software installations, and so on. Next one is a network function virtualization. So NFB separate a network key function so that they can be distributed among environment. Once a software function are independent of the physical machine, they once lived on, a specific function can be packaged together into a new network and assigned to an environment. Virtualizing network reduces the number of physical components like as a switch, router, server, cable and hubs that are needed to create a multiple independent network, and it's particularly popular in the telecommunications industries. So these are the different types of virtualizations. So in this case of virtualizations, hypervisor play a major role. So let us see what is the concept of hypervisor. Basically, hypervisor is a software. Hypervisor एक software है और ये एक तरीके की virtualization technique होती है जिसकी help से multiple operating system, जैसे कि हम बात कर लें अगर Windows का, Linux का, Mac, तो multiple operating system को सिंगल हार्डवेयर सिस्टम पर रन करने के लिए अलाउ करता है. मींस ऑन वन मशीन वी कैन रन मल्टीपल ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम लाइक एज विंडो, लिनक्स, मैक एंड सो ऑन. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम आपस में हार्डवेयर के रिसोर्स को शेयर करते हैं, लाइक एज ए प्रोसेसर को शेयर करेगा, मेमोरी को शेयर करेगा, रैम को शेयर करेगा, एंड वर्चुअलाइजेशन को हाइपरवाइजर सॉफ्टवेयर के द्वारा ही किया जाता है. हाइपरवाइजर डायरेक्टली हार्डवेयर से इंटरेक्ट करेगा और हार्डवेयर को अलग अलग पार्ट में डिवाइड करेगा. हाइपरवाइजर को वर्चुअल मशीन मैनेजर के नाम से भी जाना जाता है. सो VMM इज नथिंग बट नोन एज अ हाइपरवाइजर. बेसिकली देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ हाइपरवाइजर. फर्स्ट वन इज अ टाइप वन हाइपरवाइजर and second is a type 2 hypervisor. Type 1 hypervisor also known as a native hypervisor or bare hypervisor. So type 1 hypervisor directly host machine पर run करता है. इसे किसी भी तरह के base server या operating system की जरूरत नहीं होती है. यह hardware resource से directly interact करता है. Like as a VMware is a type 1 hypervisor. Microsoft Hyper-V is a VMware software. Oracle Virtual Machine is a type 1. In type 2, host operating system से सीधे host system पर run होता है. Means type 2 hypervisor host operating system सीधे underlying होस्ट सिस्टम पर रन होता है. मतलब ये है कि सॉफ्टवेयर डायरेक्टली ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम पर इंस्टॉल होता है. और टाइप टू हाइपरवाइजर को आप ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम से हार्डवेयर कॉल करने के लिए रिक्वेस्ट करता है. इसे होस्टेड हाइपरवाइजर भी कहा जाता है. एग्जांपल के तौर पे वीएमवेयर इज अगेन टाइप टू हाइपरवाइजर, VMware server. Microsoft Virtual PC is a type 2 hypervisor. VMware Workstation is a type 2 hypervisor. Oracle Virtual Machine या Oracle VM Virtual Box KVM is known as a type 2 hypervisor. So this one is the concept of virtualizations and the some introductory part of the hypervisor. In our next lecture, we will see detail about the hypervisor, its type, like as a type 1 hypervisor, type 0 hypervisor, and how we can virtualize operating system, how we can virtualize network, how we can virtualize hardware. These are the things we can explain in the next lecture in detail. So this one is our topic for the today lecture. Now we will meet in our next lecture for the hypervisor.